partake in this important event, which is of historical significance to the people of the Marshall Islands. I wrote something because I wanted to stay on track. In the interest of time, I will try to limit my remarks to the events surrounding the used nuclear legacy in the Marshall Islands. I think it's important that we spend some time on that. And what it means to the victims, or the people of the Marshallese, the Marshallese people were affected by the fallout. Today, 60 years ago, the world witnessed one of the most horrific spectacle and the most powerful atomic explosion in the history of mankind. Bravo shot. A used thermonuclear atomic weapon was detonated March 1st, 1954 on Bikini Atoll as part of the U.S. thermonuclear weapon testing program in the Marshall Islands. It is a day that will long live in infamy as far as the Marshallese people are concerned, especially for the people of Bikini, Romulab, Aniwita, and Wutrick, for whom fell victims to devastation of nuclear holocaust. Today is remembered in the Marshalls as the Nuclear Victims Day. Bravo shot was the first ever thermonuclear hydrogen bomb tested in the history of U.S. atomic bomb testing. It was 1,000 times more powerful than each of the atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki during World War II. The impact of which was so powerful and destructive that it vaporized parts of Bikini Island and created a crater about 6,500 feet wide and 250 feet deep in the lagoon of Bikini, and led to a widespread radioactive fallout contamination over downwind inhabited islands of Romulab and Wutrick. As a result, exposed islanders residing in Romulab and Wutrick suffered acute radiation syndrome, which includes burns, itch, nausea, vomiting, fatigue, and diarrhea, as you see in the film earlier. 2 days later, they were evacuated by military to Kwajalein, a military installation for treatment. And according to one account, there was little the military doctors could do, as they themselves never could counter such medical conditions. All of this led to President Eisenhower to finally declare a moratorium on U.S. atomic bomb testing, suspending the U.S. arms race with Soviets. Bikini was deemed the most contaminated place on Earth, according to an official of the Atomic Energy Commission. Besides Bravo, there were a total of 67 atomic bombs detonated on Bikini and Aniwita in a span of 12 years, from 1946 to 1958. That is equivalent to 1.6 Hiroshima bombs every day for 12 years. That's 1.6 Hiroshima bombs every day for 12 years. And that's equivalent to 7,000 Hiroshima bombs. That's the total yield, 7,000 Hiroshima bombs. Also, the yield of the Marshall Islands testing was 93 times the total yield of tests conducted in Nevada test sites, 93 times more. All of this resulted not only in destruction of land and lives of people, but displacement and annihilation of a culture. For Marshallese people, land means everything. It's the traditional basis of their social structure and culture. for without land there is no culture. Yet despite such devastating impact of the US nuclear weapon testing program, there has never been any serious initiative or will on the part of the US government to fully own up to its actions. For instance, to date, there has never been any real, comprehensive, robust, and quality healthcare system dedicated to full treatment and surveillance of radiogenic related illnesses. Therefore, patients oftentimes are forced to seek care elsewhere, such as the United States here in Hawaii, in search of better healthcare, since the Marshall Islands Healthcare Ministry doesn't have the diagnostic capacity to care for them. Ironically, the state of Hawaii in the past, has attempted to cut or withheld healthcare services to this population, when in fact, the medical conditions for which they're seeking treatment for are results of the nuclear testing. The recent NCI study, National Cancer Institute study, confirmed that additional access cancers over background cancers will occur among these exposed population. Today, the people of Romulup and Bikini have continued to live as nomads in their own country, for their homelands are still considered unsafe for habitation. There have been attempts in the past to return them, but none of which proved safe. Last night, I was listening to the Republic of the Marshall Islands Ambassador Tony Nibrom via a live feed from the Marshall Islands, who was the keynote speaker at the first ever Marshall Islands Nuclear Legacy Conference, in which he articulated Marshall Islands government renewed commitment to see final justice related to the nuclear issues. He said the Marshalls is not interested in blame games with the US government, but demand openness and accountability in order for the two nations to have a final closure and move forward. He said there can never be any honest dialogue and accountability without full disclosure, as there still remain information being withheld from the Marshallese people by the US government. He reminded the United States that there can never be final closure without full disclosure. There can never be final closure without full disclosure. This is the legacy of the US nuclear testing in the Marshall Islands. And since then, there has been political contentions at times and punctuated by half-starts, half-truths, and mistrust. On the 63rd nuclear victim anniversary, it is worth remembering that the nuclear legacy began in good faith on a fateful Sunday over half a century ago, when Bikinians were promised by the US naval officers that testing was done for the good of all mankind and to end all wars. And as peace and God-loving people, they willingly sacrificed their homelands. They trusted the United States. Today, they're humbly asking, where is the justice? Thank you, mahalo, o Molda.
Jim Albertini of Malawaina Peace Farm here in Kurdistan. And I've been a peace activist for over 50 years. And first of all, I was deeply moved by the talks, by the film, and it's a shameful thing the United States has done, not only to cause the problems, but then to deny and keep information from you, and keep medical, responsible medical care that should be afforded. So the United States has an awful lot of apologizing to do and repentance in the biblical sense. And so I come here with a heavy heart, and I want to join with you in that ongoing struggle for compensation, for medical care, for a deep apology on behalf of the government for the crime was committed against the Marshallese people. And I want to share too that you are the downwinders, you are ground zero in this nuclear holocaust of the world. But we too here on this island, we discovered 10 years ago that the U.S. has used radiation weapons in the center of this island at Pohakuloa. They used training weapons that contained radiation to fire a trajectory for these, what were called Davy Crockett nuclear weapons. And how many they've used, we don't know. But we've been pushing for testing, monitoring, to determine the full extent of the contamination here. Because Pohakuloa is right in the center of the islands, and there's huge winds that go through and can carry that radiation. It's not the gamma rays and the beta rays that were shown in the film that pick up very easily on meters. The radiation used here is alpha particle, and it's outside of the body is not a hazard. But if you inhale it, according to Dr. Lauren Pang, who was 25 years in the Army Medical Corps, he said alpha particles are the most deadly form of radiation once inhaled. So that's the issue we're facing here, that there is radiation from military testing here. It's blowing around the island. When people drive through the saddle, it can get on vehicles, on your shoes if you stop at the park. And who knows how much radiation people are inhaling. And so, again, I think we're going to see elevated cancers here as a wide range of effects on the islands. So in a sense, we are downwinders too. We're all downwinders. You have suffered the brunt of the nuclear age. We're part of that too. So I think we need to stand in solidarity with one another to say, no more Hiroshimas, no more bikinis, no more Pohakuloas. Aloha.
Let us pray. Amadagumaan medamanit. Lablab chama misalam kami kamula lo kini nyirin kami pakai kami mit taina walang ngana ino kuam sedagi mani izin kami cep
ari kena ari je cuan pijaya ari kapro mui mui
say a few things about the film that just broke my heart.
Ikanan mohon ada kamu lo lalik cemeru jelam kini ini nama nama cuci ku baik kanu ini.
First, I want to thank God for a wonderful evening.
Ilo jadi dia yang jual mahal dan kenono ilo dan ada begini begini.
This time, I'm going to go ahead and speak on behalf of the Bikinians. Our senator and mayor are not here at this time. Elders that were present at the time of the nuclear fallout were also not here.
In anyone my Lord Kian Camilla Lake Chili Kinchor Ranin Prawalongan. Alaman Island gain even. Him Rarchelet. A Pamin Archelet. Commander Milgain Rarchelet. Island go. Even. You do really win. Marshall Island.
I will go ahead and describe some of the things that I know and understand from what I learned as I grew up on the neighbor islands of the Marshalls about these tests, these nuclear studies that were done on the four atolls, the Marshall Islands.
More. Tagay, kapulumimit, pwede na ako kayin, rari dap chile yung walap, ang rari dako chen, prabo, tayo kayin na kamani, ilo ay nang ibigini.
These tests that were done were not tests that just came out of the blue and happened. These tests came from the plans and to test the nuclear effects on humans in the Marshall Islands.
Ijalai Kumar Kalimijat Pijayom Lo Anjuan Pijayom Ali Kabrumimit. Kena harum itu lain, ilo ayo dengan orang lap. Encik bujoin rakyat corong pamu gigi, pamu gigi yang ilo ayo dengan begini, ha, kajurin pamin, air chill, orang lap kabudret, kalau tak ada dengan masalah lain, ke masalah itu pergi dengan rakyat.
I know that you witnessed the video of the of the events that happened after the bomb was dropped on the Marshall Islands. It was very heartbreaking and sad. And these two islands that they videoed, the people of the islands that they videoed, these islands were not the islands that the bomb was dropped on. However, they were affected from the downwind, the change and shift in the wind, and therefore they were affected by the nuclear radiation. But all of the Marshall Islands were probably affected as well.
Bulan, ikan anuan, rural tel kian alat, ilo Amerika, bulan mencolok pamuin, nganayel na, ekadat kian aramizrain, jorin enot minin mur, ilo ayer kara kadat karir.
It was probably the intention of the previous administrations of the U.S. government to use our islands and our people as study subjects so they could understand the nuclear radiation effects on humans.
I don't want and not beginning. It should have lamoran. You only have to get a money. Lain kabar mengenai akan jalan, ane cuma rujuk lang, yang ada itu pun kejaran mana kemukar. Yang ada juga pilih, ngan amukar lihat kalau perenan budget, ecu lop paham orang kajur, yang pagi ni aye lagi, ecu kena ane wahabi, ak kerja kemar mengin, ya we, ar mengin cuy. Arabic in Triamo, Marcella, Chorrani, Pam, Ejok bajin korolap imparenot men korolap bilang nang ilon borin korai waro yang pang.
Our islands were pristine islands and beautiful. They were not given to us by humans. They were a gift from God. And it wasn't easy for us to let them do the testings. But because we're people who are people of aloha and we have a lot of love for other people, we were able to speak with the leaders who came and decide that maybe this was better for everyone concerned.
Kia ikanan perpajuan alen gay. Yang perpajuan itu golok ke jalan perkembangan program ini apa? Minil yang mereka lakukan mana? Nganar bilik begini. Enam orang ni, kerajaan bujang kebaikan ron, imbu kebaikan ron, imbu dalam luda naikon naik lagi begini. Cuma nana begini, ini am kalau mengelak jaga.
I will say this, as I've said before in my previous presentations, that. The U.S. might as well have collected all the sewage in the world and dropped it on our island of Bikini.
Rain, kami alam ini Bikini kalau nak agai lagi ni, kami dari mana cedar miru lecu jualan lumuri. Ecara jigi na yang per, kami perlu betul. Imejan lalu ni mlaale yang akan marom per jigi. Iloan, ecara cik bangor alat. Im kini orang mereka, kalim jaga harim jaga ini kaki yang non. Anakar kacit agi lalu yang non. Im kemar kat orang mana? Ilo ambil awak Amerika, eno cuan lalap je lalap je, lalap mui. Elakan, emelak elak air dengan awak, joget cium awak baru. Kami berbeda dulu nani awak, king cuita ke apa? Cegaran tak? Ia menjagaan ya. At kemarin ini begini. Rorat teh dada ilu jalan lawan. Kabelu jalan aman. Kami jaya wajah dengan nam. Pegumun ilok. In kau kembali ke kembali ilu. Rejeju air ilu am kalim jadi kau kembali lawan lagi. Kau encap kembali nalic. Agar kemarin kumpulan mereka.
Today, the Bikinians have no real place to call home. We travel across the U.S. and other places to see where we can find solace and make a home for ourselves. Although we realize that we are not able to be recognized as people who sacrificed our homeland because we looked up to the U.S. The U.S. was a symbol of wealth, knowledge, and security, and we had no idea that they would do this to us.
Ilangan ngay garwon malodan paylu yini na eno dar jarage yini ngay rajab siyad yini ko raay tok ag iganan bangan kumuj alug rain ral ido ko malu siyad pijay no chawden in raay din ramajagi melalay ko ramajagi chor raay ko ramajagi men ko rawr ngando na narami Aga celongan ada menjelun baru. And parcuan ada ni luar sana ada menjelun bikin ni. Train ada menjelun. Roy menjaya terjauh ini. Al Glann Lokebol. Imino Mall. Emarong ini langgan apa menjelun ya. Aga terjauh ini nolin. Kapten dan menjelun. Pagsibir, ilo rainin nga jor rainin, ralat, raja juway rin maram, amukya na nga merga. Yakam mani nga naram ijirin, ilo chad iyo kore modra.
I could go on and on tonight about many things that I want to say about the nuclear fallout and the effects on our people, but we don't have that much time tonight, as we know that our time is limited in this place. And although we BIKINIans in this church today, we're here to represent our people. Our elders are no longer around, some of whom may have passed away because of cancer, or the illnesses as a result of the nuclear fallout. Only God knows, you know, they've all gone to heaven, and we had no choice. There's nothing we can do anymore. We're helpless to do anything about what happened to our island. But all we can do is pray and keep each other strong.
Ikanan pake, ejab bikin niwat, imaran niru yir ayoran. Ayoran, ayling kain emin, imalab tata, awalaman ayilingin maazal ayilin. Cerai not cuyen, paham gaya dar kembali, nailu ahilingin begini. Ewal cecuyu ceraman, koran cepatlah, kami wadangi mincin, riang mereka, rayli dogan monai demgami, ilu angkal malau jen kami. Hampar cuyan ada, karena kampolol, ran. Ima walaupun rain matan ilok community ak cara balik inan iluan pokokan juda gini kan corran gini pokokan ran kami kamu luluk kami perpangan kujuan alat ke Cuaca gini, ilu awalnya pun kata margin, alam izin begin direct, kata margi chain iya kan iya, ani jen kejaraman kejauja alam ilu awalnya juga kubarongan, witness je, Alam taga piyay jo jara lu je ilo jode din rai.
Okay, I forgot half of what he said. Basically, he wants to thank Ron for everything that, all his efforts in trying to bring this issue out in the open. And our people have suffered a lot. And the U.S. pretty much gave us very minimal compensations. It wouldn't even cover the basic needs of what our people need medically. But we have to move on. And I just would like to say thank you, Ron, for all that you do for this issue, and we appreciate all your efforts.
Received a lot of the fallout is Reverend Glann Lokebol.
I will just speak on the project 4.1. As someone who worked with the local government office for Rongla, I know a little bit about the efforts of the leadership of Rongla. The video that we watched tonight is only a speck of what 4.1 was involved.
Hello, writing night to the visit, Armijan Rongla, chapter of Rongla Batoki.
Today, as I stand here, the people of Rongla have not been able to return to their island of Rongla.
Chijalaga, Palma, Chug Rongla, Armijan or Arpello Rongla, Kamel Milo, BIKINI, okay, Palma, Ardo, and what.
The bomb was not dropped on Ramala, but when they dropped the bomb on BIKINI Atoll, the fallout came like rain on the island and encompassed the whole island.
In Kalokin Tower Arwala, a mold, yellow rapido, palm.
All the women that you saw in the video and were giving their testimonies of their experiences and sufferings were all women who were present during the fallout.
em chon crazy etanin nation ak ni lang emol menoy kono wala ke army chen rom la ke re nangan me jim re mit e jido rebel le un poker e ma kada kaver tawara wala ben pelir chorain ni.
One of the women you may have remembered on the video, her name was Nijon Ignilam. Her story was true. She explained that the people, their people were, when they got sick and they passed away, they were treated like animals, examined like animals.
Kia, and other bagay pun, chichalagin, chorangin, ilo 4.1 kitchen, paminar walo, ilo ayangin maizal, ejila darminin rongla. Okay? Arminin rongla, mechuk chum loka kachitak chibang, eem rajay ku chibang, ilo ayperin mur ilo rangin, ilo ay per chogo chabro ilo langin.
The damages from 4.1 in the Marshall Islands, mainly to the Ronald people, continue to cause suffering and illnesses in the people there today. I mean, in their families. And they continue to ask for help. Today, wherever they are, in the U.S. or in the Marshall Islands.
Chidalagan Arvin Chorangi, Dikitin, Rarchila than Bindam, Iroa, Iroa and Roland. Raining, Kijitongan, Lalagin and Riamara, in Kapuk Chibang, Rajiva, Kimmy Civil Isabel.
We know about all the illnesses that were caused by the radioactive fallout. And some of us today, when we ask the U.S., when we go to the U.S. and we ask for their assistance, or when we ask for assistance here, for the benefits that could help us get treated for these illnesses, we are told that we're not eligible.
Meno mam tatay, ikna ang kwairo chodin in rainin. Chitka mulo lani che meru jilang o me. Kaysalay minu dami chitcha. Im kujo jit tamagay rainin. Ini jalan yang merah lebar tanam. Kau jalan cuma naan yang lebok. Aku mengani jenuh moli kami kerku bado. Di jalan ini. Keur cetai dia aku. Lama kor beriper. Penol menerin aku bado. Kentain. Arwalok im arcilat. Armisin rolat im. Armisin begini im. Armisin masalah. Kau mengani jenuh moli.
The only thing we can do right now is probably just thank God for, we can only trust in Him, for He knows everything, and we know that we can trust Him. We know that there are people here who may be able to give us ideas on how to proceed, on what to do to help ourselves. But in the meantime, we shall just leave our trust in God's hands. Thank you very much for your presence tonight.
Pastor Glann Lokebol, This doesn't give you the breadth of what happened, but on the sheet of paper in the back, we have a little bit more how you can go and find out more, how you can even order the Nuclear Savage DVD. The long version is 87 minutes, and you should see all of it. And there are other things and ways to contact us.